Welcome, dear students, to the lecture series of Data Structures and Algorithm. Today, we will be understanding the implementation of BFS and DFS algorithm using C programming language. In the previous video, we have seen how to perform the BFS and DFS traversal on graph. Now, let us understand the program for the same. Very first, if we have given a graph, say for example, there is a directed graph, okay? So to perform, I will first have to create an adjacency matrix for the graph, okay? So adjacency matrix for the same can be created like this, okay? So here I have some 9 number of nodes. So for each of them, what I'm doing is I'm creating 9 rows and 9 columns. So it is a two-dimensional matrix of 9 × 9. Wherever there is an edge between any two nodes, say for example, there is an edge between node A to B. So from row A to column B, there will be value 1. Similarly, if there is an edge from E to C, so from node row E and column C, there will be an edge showing with value 1. Rest other cases, wherever there is no edge, we are writing it as 0. So we are done with the adjacency matrix. Next, we will also require a matrix that is called as a visited matrix. So here we will be writing all the number of all the nodes that we have. Okay, suppose here I have 9 nodes. So I will have a single dimensional array of location 0 to 9. Okay, initially I keep all the values as 0. So this is all about the matrices. Now let us see the code. So here I have created this code. Now this is for the BFS and DFS traversal for the graph. Here we have declared a max size that is 5. So the array which I will be using, considering if it is having 5 nodes, yeah. So I will be creating the array of 5 × 5. Then I have declared 2 different functions. First is breadth first function. Okay, I have defined this function. Then I have done depth first search function. Okay. Here I have written a main function. So we'll first understand the main function. Here what we are doing is we have created 2 matrix. The first is visited matrix of size max. This is a single dimensional matrix, okay, where I am putting 0 value in the beginning for this visited matrix. So you can see here this is a visited matrix which is having all values that is 0, okay. And the next is this adjacency matrix that is having 2-dimensional matrices, which is max cross max. So here there are 5 nodes, okay. So it will be 5 × 5, 2-dimensional matrix, okay. That is called as an adjacency matrix. So I'm giving this name as a adjacency matrix here, okay. So this is all about it. Now here in this main function, what we are doing is I'm using a do while loop, and in that I'm using a switch case, okay. So I'm giving the option, the first is enter the values in your graph. So very first, user has to enter the case 1, yeah. So case 1 says you have to enter the values in your adjacency matrix. So if I will take 2 for loop, okay. First for loop is for rows and second for loop is for columns. So for each row, I am putting all the values in each columns, and the value which I am scanning, I am storing in that in the adjacency matrix at that particular row and column location. So if I have a matrix for 9 nodes, the matrix will be like this. So I'm going to enter the values as given in this particular matrix. Okay. After entering all the values in your adjacency matrix, your graph is fed into the system. Now we can traverse using either BFS or DFS. So we will call DFS and BFS function over here. Okay. And fourth is the exit option. So when I want to call the BFS function, what I'm doing is I'm just calling the function. I'm providing 3 values as the input. First is the adjacency matrix. Second is visited array. So visited array by default will be 0 as shown over here. And then we are giving some start node. So I want to start traversal from which node? Maybe from A, maybe from B, maybe from G. Okay. So we have to tell which node to start with. So here, when I say A, it is actually location number 0. When I say B, it is location number 1. So A, B, C, D are represented by location 0, 1, 2, 3. So if I want to say A, I will write 0, that is location 0. And that's why I'm writing this number 0 here. That means I want to start traversal from node A. What if I want to start the traversal from node E?
So I should be giving 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I should be saying number 4 here if I want to start with node E. Hope this is clear with everyone. So these are the three inputs that we are giving to the function, and we are calling breadth first search and depth first search here. So that's it about this main function. Now we will go and understand this breadth first search algorithm first. Okay, so here is this breadth first search algorithm. We are taking as an input the adjacency matrix, the visited array, and the start or the node from which we want to start. So let's see here, BFS traversal. So if the graph is given to us, we will use this adjacency matrix, visited array, and the start node. These are the three inputs which are given by the user. Now I will use a queue over here, okay, to use this breadth first search algorithm. Okay, now initially my queue is empty. So what I have to do, first of all, I will have to make my rear and front is equal to minus 1 just to make sure that my queue is empty. So what will I do is, I will first say my front and rear both equal to minus 1. After that, what I'm doing is, my visited array, suppose if your visited array is having some non-zero values, make sure all of them are zero values. So I'm using a for loop here to make all my values in the visited array to become zero. Okay, now what I'm doing is, now I'm starting with the algorithm for breadth first search. So breadth first search, what it is doing, it reads the first node. Now we want to start with the node 0. So what it will do? It will start with node 0. So Q, we are incrementing, pre-incrementing rear. Okay. So after incrementing rear, so here I'm incrementing rear. That means rear will become 0 now. Okay. So what will happen? I'm saying that increment rear by 1. Okay. And we have to put 0 in that. So what I'm doing, Q of 0 is equal to start. But start is also holding the value 0. That is representing node A. So node A is represented by value 0. So once I have entered any node in my queue, I have to mark it is visited. And that's why I make visited for A as 1. Okay. Now next, what I'm doing is, So here I'm done with this line. Also, I'm incrementing my front by 1. So both rear and front are pointing to 0. Now what we're doing is visited of start also equals to 1. So visited of 0 is also made 1. Now I'm entering a while loop. This while loop will end only when your queue is empty. Okay. So till the time your queue is not empty, it will run. So what is this condition? While rear is greater than equal to 0, that means you have some values in your queue. So what it will do? It will every time, it will take out some value from the front and increment the front by 1. That means it is deleting one value from the front and storing that value in the variable called as a start. And then I'm printing or displaying that start to the user. So here, there is only one value in my queue. So what I'm doing is, I'm just removing that value from the queue. So when I remove, actually, I increment by front by 1. So front is going to one position ahead. So I'm printing 0. That means I'm printing A. So whenever I say 0, it is A. That's why I'm printing A. Okay. Now after printing this, what I have to do? After deleting any value, we have to put or add its neighbors. Okay. So add neighbors of the value which we deleted. So how do we find the neighbors of A? Okay, so we will go from 0 to max. Okay, a simple for loop. In this, we will find out in the adjacency matrix. The start is nothing but value A, the node which you just deleted. So for that node, we are checking the entire row from location 0 to 1. That means for this row of A, I'm checking values from 0 till 8. So all these values I'm checking, and what is the condition over there? If that value is 1, if adjacency start is like this, I'm given, there is no is equal to condition. That means if the value is 1. So wherever the value is 1, that is for 1, 2 and 3, the value is 1. Okay. And also the visited of that is 0. So for, you can say here for 1, 2, 3, this is 1. Yes. And for 1, 2, 3, whether the visited is 0, yes. So for 1, 2, 3, visited is also 0 and the value is also present in that row. So what will I do now? I will enqueue or add those values in my queue at the rare end. So I will increment the rare of my queue, and at the rare of the queue, I will add the value I. I is nothing but this location, that is 1, 2 and 3. So what I'm doing over here is, if you see the queue here, I have added 1, 2 and 3 in my queue. And now my rare is pointing to the last most added number, that is 3. Okay, once I add these 3 values in my queue, I have to make their visited also 1. Okay, because those are added in the queue. So whichever are added in the queue, that visited should be made as 1. So I am doing it over here. This is done. So now next what we will do. Now we are done with this if loop and we are coming out. So we are done with the for loop. So for loop is over, but the while loop is not yet over. That means your queue is not yet empty. So till the queue is not empty, we will be inside this while loop. Okay. So what we will do here, again I will go. Okay. And what will I do? Start is equal to queue front. That means delete one value from the start. So here now who is at the start? Who is at the front? 1. So I have to delete 1. So what will I do next? I am deleting 1. So for 1, what value should be printed? For 1, B value should be printed. That's why I am printing B. Whenever I delete something, what I am doing? I am pushing its neighbor inside this. So what are the neighbors of B that I have to check in this adjacency matrix? So there is only one value which is available. So there is only one neighbor of B, which is at location 4. Is the 4 adjacency visited matrix 0? Yes. Then I can add this 4 value into my queue. So here I am adding 4 into the queue. Okay. And making its visited as 1. Now again, next what I will do is I will delete one value from the front. That is what we are doing is we are deleting one by one each and every value. Okay. So here I have deleted 2. So when I delete 2, what is the notation for 2? That is node C. That's why I will print C. Okay, and then I will find out the neighbors of C. Okay, so I found some 2 neighbors of C, that is 1 and 6. Okay, here these are the neighbors of C. But as we see, 1 is already visited. So we need not to add 1 now. But 6 is not visited. So yes, we can add 6 in the queue. Yeah, so I will simply add only 6 in the queue and make it as a visited over here. Okay, and again we will delete something from the front. Say for example, if I'm deleting 3 from the front, okay, so then I'm displaying D over here. So like this, it will keep on doing in this particular do while loop or the for loop. And then again, I'm finding out the neighbors of D, okay, and those neighbors I'm pushing inside the particular queue. So here, this while loop will keep on executing until unless you have the queue having some values. Once your queue is empty, that means your front is greater than rare. At that time, we will come out of the while loop, and at that place, all the nodes will be visited. They will be printed over there. Okay, all those which are reachable from node 0 will be printed on the as an output. Okay, so to print any node, and now I'm referring every node as a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I want to print A, B, C, D. So how do I do that? So I just have to display a ASCII value for that particular character. Say for example, whenever the start value is holding A, I want to just represent A. I'm indicating A with 0. So 0 plus 65 is actually making A. Okay, so 65 is the ASCII value for A. So 0 plus 65 will give me character A. And instead of printing numerical value, I'm printing character. So though I'm printing character here, I'm actually printing A. If I want to print B, I will simply say 1 plus 65 will print B. 2 plus 65 will print C. Like that, using numbers and adding 65 to it, if I'm displaying character, I can display my ABCD node names over there. So this is all about the BFS traversal technique. Now let's understand the depth first search algorithm. Again, same like BFS, here we check 3 inputs from the user. First is adjacency matrix, then the visited array, and then the start node. Okay. So here how we'll do with the DFS traversal. Okay. Now in DFS traversal, the graph will be given to us. Adjacency matrix user is providing. Visited array also it is providing. And the start node from which I want to start the traversal is also provided. But here, instead of using queue, I'm using stack. So initially your stack is empty. That means your top should be pointing to minus 1. So here my top is pointing to minus 1. Okay. So what do I do? I will first create a stack, okay, of size max. That is how many number of nodes are there. That much size of stack I am declaring. Then I am declaring my top to be minus 1. That is my stack is empty. Initially, I will make sure that my visited array having all values 0. So I will make sure that all the values in the visited array are 0 by using a for loop. Now what I am doing is I want to start displaying the values from the depth first search. So I will first push a value to the stack. So which value to push first? The user, whatever user has sent to start with. So that is stored in the variable start. So variable start, I'm pushing to the stack. So what is there in the variable stack? 0. That means node A. So when I say 0, it is node A. So A I'm pushing to the stack at the first location. That means at the top, I'm putting value 0. Okay. Now what I'm doing is, after putting a value 0 over there, we have to, okay, this part you simply ignore. Okay, we are covering it later. Now what I'm doing, once I put 0 to the stack, I have to make its visited also 1. So what I'm doing here, its visited array, I'm making 0 is visited. That's why I'm making it is 1. Now, once I have added 1 value to the stack, I have to enter the while loop. This while loop will get over only when your stack has become empty. So till your stack is not empty, it will not stop. Okay, so whenever your stack is empty, that time only we will come out of the while loop. So what are we doing in this while loop? Actually, we'll first pop out one value from the stack. Okay, and that value I'm storing in a variable stack start. So what I'm doing here, I'm popping out a value. Okay, after popping out, I'm storing that value, I'm printing that value. Okay, so what I popped out? 0. That's why I'm printing A, because 0 plus 65 will give me ASCII value. After popping out the value A, what I have to do is I have to find its neighbors. Okay, so let's just see with the program. After popping out, I have to simply print A. So yes, I have printed A here. Now I have to find the neighbors of A and push them to the stack. So here in this particular for loop, I'm finding the neighbors and I'm pushing them to the stack. So how I'm doing? Adjacency matrix for that row. Okay, and if the visited is also 0. So here I'm finding the row A. Okay, so row of A is this first row, okay, which belongs to 0. In this first row, whichever values are 1, for those values, I'm finding the visited value. Okay, so now here 1, 2 and 3 are not, there are some edges. And for 1, 2, 3, the visited is also 0. That means we can add this 1, 2, 3 to the stack. Yes. So we will, these are the neighbors of A, we will add them to the stack. So what I'm doing is I'm adding 1, 2, 3 to the stack and making their visited also 1. So the same thing I'm doing in a code, I'm adding those values to the stack at the top and making their visited as 1. Okay, so this we are doing in a for loop for all those members. So here I'm doing for all the neighbors, I'm adding them to the stack. Getting it? So I can say this entire for loop is for adding neighbors of the value which we just printed. After adding the neighbors, what we have done? We are done with the for loop. Now we will repeat the same step again and again in the entire while loop, okay, till our stack is becoming empty. But now my stack is not empty. So what will I do in the while loop again? Again, I will pop out the value from the top. Now which I pop out? I pop out 3. So what is 3 actually? 3 is here. That means it is which value? A, B, C, D. So that means I'm printing D. Okay. And after printing D, I have to find the neighbors of D. So what are the neighbors of D? That is these two neighbors. So among them, 2 and 6 are the neighbors. Are they both visited? 2 is already visited, so we cannot add it. But 6 is not visited. So I will only add 6 over here. That means I'm adding 6 over here. And I'm making 6 as visited. After that, again, I'm popping out topmost value. Okay. And then I will print that value for 6. What is a character coming there? So that is start from 0 as A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So I'm printing G here. Then I'm finding the neighbors of G. So what are the neighbors of G? These are the neighbors of G. Among them, 5, 7, 8. So 5, 7, 8, none of them is visited. So we can add all of them in the queue. So what I'm doing, I'm adding all of them in the queue over here. Okay. So like this, we'll keep on doing this till our stack is becoming empty. Once a stack has become empty, we come out of the while loop. Okay. And when we come out of the while loop, our function is over. That means in this particular function, if the start value is given to us, we will print all the values which are reachable from that node in BFS traversal technique. Okay, so this is all about the BFS and DFS traversal techniques. We have done with a program. Okay, so I will just explain you once again the what is there in the program. First of all, I'm writing this to header files. Max, I'm writing the size of the nodes in my array. You can give any size that you want. And then I'm writing two functions. First is breadth first search function. Okay, after this function, I'm writing depth first search function. After this function, I'm writing integer main. In integer main, I'm using two arrays, that is visited and adjacency matrix. Here I'm using do while loop in which I'm giving four options. First is enter the adjacency matrix values in the graph. Second is BFS traversal. Third is DFS traversal. And fourth is exit. Then in a switch case, I'm handling all these operations. When I want to enter the values in the adjacency matrix, I'm using a combination of two for loop together to scan and add the values in the adjacency matrix, which is two-dimensional. Then in case 2, I'm calling the BFS function. In case 3, I'm calling DFS function. And whenever user press 4, that is exit, we will come out of the while loop using this line. Okay. And here we are finished with the main function. So that's it about the BFS and DFS implementation using graph. Okay. So now we will just test an output. So we will try to run our program. Now let's run a program. Suppose if this is the matrix graph given to us, which is having five number of nodes. So I will write down the adjacency matrix for this. So if this is the adjacency matrix, I'll try to add these values into my as an output, and I will see what is the traversal coming over there. So I will run my code here. So now it is asking enter the values in the graph. I will go with the option one. I'm entering the values in the graph. My graph is having five nodes. Okay, so I will enter the matrix which is having five cross five matrix. So the first row is having values. This second row. Okay, third row. Fourth row. Then fifth row. Okay. After adding all the values, I will now call BFS traversal. That is option number 2. So now it is saying that A, B, C, D, E. Now let us go and check it. So here, if I just see, BFS traversal will start from node A, as I'm giving the start node is 0. From A, I can get reach A, B and C. So what BFS does, it first write down your first neighbors. So after A, it will print B, C, D because those are its first neighbors. And after that, neighbors of neighbors. So E will come in neighbors of neighbors. So obviously, D's neighbor is E. And because of that, E will be printed at the last. That means the answer that we are getting, it is A, B, C, D, E is correct. Now we will run option number 3, that is DFS traversal. It is giving us the answer as A, B, D, E, C. Now let us check that for DFS traversal. Okay, so DFS does goes in depth first. So after reading A, it is reading B. Okay, so one of the neighbor of A, then the neighbor of neighbor. So who is the neighbor of B? It's D. Okay, then neighbor of neighbor. So D's neighbor is E, and then neighbor of that neighbor is C. So it is going in depth. That means after A, it is going to B, then it is going to D, then it is going to E, and then C. That is A, B, D, E, C. As we can see here, this is the traversal that we are getting. And option 4 will stop the function. Okay. So with this, we have learned this particular program. I hope you all have understood this. If any doubts, and you can ask me in the comment box. Okay. And please do subscribe to this channel for more videos. Thank you.